restored.
You said this was going to be the year that
room. You could have been in the delivery room and prayed, Lord Jesus, come in this room. You could have been in a courtroom and said, Lord Jesus, come in that room. I don't understand. How is it that we can beg for Jesus to come in the hospital room? Beg for Jesus to come in the courtroom. Beg for Jesus to come in out of living room. Beg for Jesus to come in the jailhouse. Beg for Jesus to come into the room between our two ears. But when he comes in this room, we act like we don't know.
If I stop fighting about it and pray about it, then maybe God will do something different.
Come on. Amen.
See, because God will do a new thing, but you got to get out of the way.
Yes.
You can't bring your preconceived notions into what God is doing.
Amen.
Y'all see in this church, when Isaiah said, I will do a new thing, says the Lord, he said, but you got to forget the former thing.
Right. Amen.
The things of old. He said, don't dwell on the past.
Right.
And a lot of times, God can't bless us with a great future because we keep holding on. By the past, past pain, past problem, past issue, past circle, past relationship. Amen. Sometimes God wants to bless you with something brand new, but you're so stuck on the past, God can't give you nothing.
Amen.
Anytime God get ready to bless you, you got to release the past. See, you can't have Wednesday and Thursday at the same time. You can't have tomorrow and yesterday at the same time. In order for